Managing weeds and brush and fence rows is an important part of any livestock operation. However, this management practice is often overlooked. Hello, I'm Greg Hicks, County Extension Director with the University of Florida Office Extension in Hamilton County.
Weeds and brush, if not controlled, will short out electric fences, spread into pastures, and make routine maintenance, such as changing a fence post or nailing fence staples, a difficult task. There are many herbicides available that will target weeds and will not kill grasses. The first step in herbicide selection is to identify what weeds you are trying to control. Once this is established, the herbicide product label will tell you what weeds it will target, the mixing rate, application rate, if an adjuvant is needed to improve the effectiveness, and if there are any precautions after application, such as grazing restrictions. The product label will state what PPE, personal protective equipment, is required for safe application of the product, such as long pants, long sleeve shirt, protective gloves, shoes plus socks, hat, and eye protection. Post-emergent herbicide activity can either be selective or non-selective. Selective herbicides target specific plants, while non-selective herbicides will kill any plant they contact. Triclopyr is an example of a selective herbicide that will control most woody plants and many broadleaf weeds and vines, but will not control grasses. Established grasses such as Bahia and Bermuda will tolerate this herbicide. Glyphosate is an example of a non-selective herbicide that will kill a variety of broadleaf and grassy weeds when applied to the foliage of actively growing plants. However, it has no residual in the soil and will require repeated applications. If you have limited fencing to manage, a hand-carried sprayer may be all you need. They are available in many sizes and will allow you to easily target specific plants. Another option is a boomless sprayer. They also come in many sizes and can be placed on or pulled behind an ATV or UTV. They operate directly from the vehicle's battery source. A nice feature of these type units is that they are available with a handheld spray gun and a hands-free boomless spray system. You should calibrate the sprayer to ensure you will be applying the appropriate amount of chemical needed for control. Time your spray application with good weather conditions. Windy weather will cause spray drift and possibly harm desirable plants. Prolonged drought will reduce the effectiveness of plant absorption, and rainfall could wash off the herbicide. The label will usually indicate whether a rain-free period is necessary and for how long. Some herbicides are labeled as restricted use and require a pesticide applicator license to purchase and apply. If you would like to become a certified applicator, check with your local county extension office. Your extension agent can also assist you with weed identification and many other management practices. For more information on weed management, research the following University of Florida Extension publications.